in the meeting, Ms. Ursula Müller, Asia and the Pacific.
Since the beginning of the military operation by the Turkish armed forces and allied non-state armed groups in northeast Syria earlier this month, the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights has received concerning reports of civilian casualties and damage to critical civilian infrastructure. The military operation has severely impacted the humanitarian situation. The hostilities have triggered large population movements. In the last 2 weeks, almost 180,000 people, including close to 80,000 children, have fled south from the border areas between Turkey and Syria.
The October 17th joint statement paved the way for a permanent ceasefire. We're hopeful, based on assurances from Turkish and Syrian Democratic Forces authorities, that the permanent ceasefire will be honored, civilian lives will be protected, and the hard-fought territorial defeat of ISIS will be preserved. This is a solution that will save lives and contribute to long-term stability in the region.
The country, to date, the UN Children's Fund,
Как мы неоднократно говорили, мы с пониманием относимся к стремлению Турции предпринять шаги, направленные на обеспечение своей национальной безопасности. При этом важно понимать, что проблема северо-востока Сирии возникла не вчера и не сегодня. Причина дестабилизации в Заефрате заключается в незаконной оккупации данного района и опасном эксперименте демографического инжиниринга, который там ставился в попытке противопоставления курдского и арабского населения.
From the very first day, the objectives of the Operation Peace Spring have been clear. To eliminate the long-standing existential terror threat along our border with Syria, to enforce Syria's territorial integrity and unity, to protect the local population and create an environment conducive to the voluntary, safe, and dignified return of Syrians to their homes. The operation was conducted in full respect of international and international humanitarian law. It only targeted terrorists and their hideouts, weapons and vehicles. We took all necessary measures to prevent any harm to civilians and damage to civilian infrastructure.